ये जो इंडिया है ना, नो वन हियर डिजर्व दिस मैस क्रिमेशंस, फैमिलीज क्रिमेटिंग देयर डियर वंस ऑन द फुटपाथ, बॉडीज ऑफ द डेड पाइलिंग अप इनह्यूमनली, पीपल डाइंग बिकॉज एन ऑक्सीजन सिलेंडर और एन आईसीयू बेड और अ डॉक्टर वॉज नॉट अवेलेबल।
बड़े भाई थे 38 साल के, रिकवर हो गए थे, ऑक्सीजन पे थे, मेरे सामने तड़प के ऑक्सीजन की मशीन बंद हो गई, कुछ नहीं आ रहा था, मेरे सामने तड़प के खत्म हुए।
पीपल डाइंग बिकॉज वी डिड नॉट बॉदर टू अनलॉक इंडियाज फुल कैपेसिटी टू प्रोड्यूस वैक्सीन। वाई हैव वी कम टू दिस पॉइंट? अनफॉर्चुनेटली इट्स नॉट जस्ट द वायरस, इट इज ऑल्सो पॉलिसी पैरालिसिस, द फेलियर टू एक्ट और द रिफ्यूजल टू एक्ट or acting far too late. That is how we have dealt with key aspects of the COVID crisis, which is why as of 21st April, we have almost 2 lakh people dead, over 20 lakh active cases, almost 3 lakh new cases every day. Policy paralysis was the stick used to beat the UPA 2 government with, but this time, the cost of policy paralysis is many, many lives. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट वैक्सीन्स। द सरकार स्लोगन वॉज जब तक दवाई नहीं तब तक ढिलाई नहीं। द गवर्नमेंट न्यू दैट वैक्सीन्स वर द की, बट वॉट वॉज डन टू रेज प्रोडक्शन? ऑलमोस्ट नथिंग। While countries like the US and UK gave advance funding to vaccine makers, India's biggest vaccine producers, Serum Institute and Bharat Biotech, got no government support. Serum Institute invested 2,000 crores of its own money and got rupees 2,200 crores from the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation to increase capacity. Bharat Biotech relied on internal resources. But why did Bill and Melinda Gates have the wisdom to support India's biggest vaccine maker and not our own government? By August 2020, the US government had invested 44,700 crores, $6 billion, across several vaccine companies including Moderna, Pfizer, Johnson & Johnson, even while they were developing and testing vaccines. That is what governments do. They think ahead. Why did we let all these months go by? Why did we wait till 19th April 2021 to advance 4,500 crores to our vaccine makers? The answer is policy paralysis. And another fact, India's current vaccine production capacity is not enough to meet even half of our monthly need of around 200 million doses. Our government has always known this. But to make up for the shortfall, did we book vaccines from other producers? No. By August 2020, the US had pre-booked 400 million vaccine doses from 4 different pharma companies. The European Union had pre-booked 800 million doses by November 2020. Do you know when India placed its first vaccine order? And that too only for 16 million doses? In January 2021. For a country of 1.3 billion people, why so little? Why so late? The answer is policy paralysis. Only now, with the second surge raging, with deaths and active cases at all-time highs, only now has our government asked foreign vaccine makers to bring their vaccines into India. But those companies are now overbooked, pre-booked. Will they be able to supply to India immediately? No, not before thousands more have died, lives that could have been saved.
In the last 2-3 days, along with me, the entire team, we are receiving calls from families which are literally begging to us, crying and asking, sir, get us one bed, my mother is dying, my son is dying, get us one injection of remdesivir, we are not able to arrange it.
Okay, let's talk about oxygen. See these desperate tweets. Again and again, families pleading for oxygen, doctors pleading for oxygen. Several state governments asking the center for oxygen.
मैं डॉक्टर परिहार भोपाल से, शासन से, प्रशासन से हाथ जोड़कर अपील करना चाहूंगा कि ऑक्सीजन की कमी से लोग मर रहे हैं, कृपया ध्यान दें, 8-8 घंटे, 9-9 घंटे लाइन में लग के हॉस्पिटल की वैन को एक 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 सिलेंडर मिल रहा है. आप सोचिए 10-10 पेशेंट एक सिलेंडर में कैसे सर्वाइव करें.
इन द सेकेंड कोविड सर्ज मेनी हैव बीन किल्ड नॉट बाय द वायरस बट बाय ऑक्सीजन शॉर्टेज. लाइव्स दैट कुड हैव बीन सेव्ड. द वेबसाइट स्क्रोल रिपोर्ट्स दैट इन अक्टूबर 2020 ऑलरेडी मेनी मंथ्स लेट द मोदी गवर्नमेंट फ्लोटेड टेंडर्स फॉर 162 ऑक्सीजन प्रोड्यूसिंग यूनिट्स टू बी सेट अप इन 150 डिस्ट्रिक्ट हॉस्पिटल्स अक्रॉस इंडिया. द कॉस्ट जस्ट 201 crore rupees, fully funded by the PM CARES Fund. Today, 6 months later, do you know how many of these 162 units have been installed? Only 33. In UP, out of 14 units, do you know how many oxygen units have been installed? Zero. Is there a shortage of oxygen at these 150 district hospitals today? Yes, there is, because of which people are dying. Do we know why? Yes, policy paralysis. The cost of these 162 oxygen units, all of them, was just 200 crores, a tiny amount for the government. But there just wasn't enough interest in getting the job done. Next, have you heard of B1.1.67? It's the Indian origin double mutant strain of the coronavirus. Many experts believe it's the main cause of the second COVID surge, the main cause of thousands of deaths that we are seeing now. But do you know when this strain of the virus was detected? On the 5th of October 2020. Immediately, red flags should have gone up. Thousands of samples of this strain should have been put through gene sequencing to understand it better, how to treat it better, maybe even modify India's vaccines to counter this deadly strain. But again, we moved too slowly. An Indian Express report says we did nothing in October, November, December. Only in January, a COVID genomics consortium, a network of 10 labs, was created to speed up genome sequencing in India with a budget of 115 crore rupees. But it's April now, and these labs have achieved very little. Do you know why? Because the central government did not give 115 crores to the Department of Biotechnology. The department was told to find the money on its own, and the department was able to allocate the first amount of 80 crores only on 31st March. 6 priceless months after this deadly strain was actually detected. As we all know, by 31st March, the second surge had already gone out of hand. Lakhs of cases, thousands of deaths, lives that we failed to save. Why? Because of policy paralysis. There are other questions too. Why was a go-ahead given to religious gatherings like the Kumbh Mela? Didn't the government know it would be impossible to impose COVID norms there? They knew. Lekin Aastha aur Gaurav ke saamne health kya cheez hai? After first allowing a mega super spreader event, it was hurriedly wrapped up, but we know the damage is already done. Then again, why was permission given for massive election rallies during the ongoing assembly elections, followed by backtracking now? Again, by holding these daily super spreader political rallies for weeks, the damage has already been done. And finally, lockdown. Last year's lockdown policy was seriously flawed, imposed without warning, stopping all trains and buses, forcing lakhs of migrant workers to walk home in the middle of the pandemic. It caused immense pain. And yet the government congratulated itself repeatedly for imposing one of the strictest lockdowns in the world. So now prepare to be more confused, as the PM has issued a plea on 20th April against lockdowns. So, lockdown, no lockdown, partial lockdown, what is the government's policy to counter the second surge? We actually don't know. That is policy paralysis. Meanwhile, migrant workers are again rushing home. The economy will take a hit again, and yet again, thousands will die. All we know is that ye jo India hai na, it's thousands of families whose dear ones have died. The lakhs who are struggling for ICU beds, oxygen, vaccines across the country, they all deserve better.